world is coming down. And there's no use in us trying to grip it, grab hold of everything. Because the world is coming down. Things are getting worse. But the message that got today, I had to rock it to get here. I think Elder Sewell said in the Bible class, when he's around the man, said, everybody talking, they want to be a benefit. You better be careful what you ask for. Now, this is a testimony of mine before I get started. In that bathroom this morning, I was like Phillip, wrestling with the angels. Lord, I was wrestling with that devil. I mean, that devil attacked me in the bathroom. And I wrestled and wrestled, and my body's still going through. But I know God is able. Yes. Came out the bathroom, he's still attacked. And my wife told me they just tried to stop me from preaching that message. And it doesn't make any difference. Because no weapon.
Persecuting them, even unto the strange city.
Whereupon, as shining round about me, and them which journey with me. And when we were all fallen to the earth, I heard a voice speaking unto me and saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? It is hard to kick against the prick. And he said, and I said, who art thou, Lord? And he said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. But rise and stand upon thy feet, for I have appeared unto thee for this purpose, to make thee a minister and a witness both of these things which thou hast seen, and of those things in which I will appear unto thee. Delivering me from the people and from the Gentile, unto whom now I send thee, to open their eyes and to turn them from darkness to light, and from the power of Satan unto God, that they may receive forgiveness of sin and inheritance among them which are sanctified by faith that is in me. Amen. If I was to use for a thought, that thought would be Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the answer. Now Paul was giving a testimony to a prisoner, because he was taken into prison as a prisoner. And he told him the thing that happened to him. Says we can testify about some of the things that happened to us and what we've done out there. And the Lord appeared to us and brought us in that we might be able to have salvation. There are many today that are trapped like Paul was in the midst. There are many out there in different churches, in the streets, and everywhere that have a great zeal for the Lord, but they don't have a knowledge. There are many people that are trapped in your homes, some wives trapped by men, won't let them out of the house and let them do what they want to do. Some in torture. Some men in the same position are being trapped by their wives. Girlfriends trapped by men. Can't do what they want to do and be in control. There are so many people that are, you can say, imprisonment. Because they don't know what to do or how to get out of this. But I know a man. I know a man. His name is Jesus. And Jesus is the answer. He can deliver you in whatever situation that you're in. When Jesus came to Paul, he told him, I'm going to make you a minister that you can go to the Gentiles. And he wanted to preach to them and bring them out of darkness into light. Deliver him from the hole of the devil. Is that what he did to us? Isn't that what he did to us? Like what the elder just said a few minutes ago, when I was out there, I was a good devil. And I served the devil good, strong. But that don't mean nothing to the Lord, because God knew my enemy from my beginning. And thank God for his mercy that he brought us in. Jesus said, come unto me, all you that are laden and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for my yoke is easy and my burdens are light. Those that are in the presence Jesus said, I'll never leave you and I will never forsake you. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Not that he came, like folks say. I heard this, I got here late this morning, I heard in Sunday school about the false doctrine. Don't let them folks give you false doctrine. God did not come down here and wrap yourself up in flesh. He said he gave a third better than change what gave me. His only begotten son. And that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Jesus is the answer. So those that are going through, trapped in their body of sin, Jesus is the answer.
Yes, he is.
Those that are going through with their children, don't know what to do. Jesus is the answer. Those that are going through finance, Jesus is the answer.
Amen.
But you know what the devil's doing now? The government's giving people all kinds of money.
Yes, he is.
Trying to make them feel comfortable out there, telling them they don't need God. Everybody seems to be getting comfortable now. They're not looking around to see what's happening. They're not looking at Israel. They're not looking at the other countries going on. They're not looking at what our president is doing. All they're looking at is what they got. But that's a trap in that money.
Amen.
They're not going to give you all that money for nothing.
Yeah.
darkness unto the light. I want you to deliver them from the devil. And that's what we have to do too. We got to give them Jesus a little hand. Because how are you going to give Jesus a hand? What did the scripture say? We are the light of the world. They got to see the love among us. And we got that. But the world got to see it. And not only do they have to see it, we can't have our shut up just in this building.
Amen.
I see my brother in the night, I want to give him a hug. Show him that I love him. You know, let me say something. I don't know that I get the wrong impression. And I've been doing this ever since she was a little girl. Sister Christian. We were going to the same school. Sister Phillip, I get people stuck in the heat all the time anyway.
Amen.
That was just me. I was learning that from my grandmother. But every day, Sister Christmas, since she worked something, I never sent to her boss.
Amen.
I'm serious. And everybody in all the other bus will be looking. So I remember you taking that to. I said, take it to my daughter. And it got so to the point to where they talk about, I think he liked her.
Oh,
she had a devil cookie.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what the people say. You keep showing love.
Amen.
That's how people gonna tell that we belong to Jesus.
Amen.
That's how people gonna tell that we're saved. There's a many people out there running around with Bibles up under their head.
Mm-hmm.
Even my boss, I have drink here. And cash going in the TV industry.
Yep.
We have to be an example. And we look at it, but God gave me this message. Jesus is the answer. Even his saint. We're going through hard times. We're going through great temptations. We're going through storms in our bodies and in our minds. Jesus is the answer.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Yes,
he is.
All we have to do is give up. Give up to the Lord. I pray you humble yourself as a little child. People don't want to do that. People now want to talk back. They want to fight back. But if you humble yourself as a child, how do you think all the people back in the old days died? Because they couldn't fight back. And they killed men. But it's all right. We humble ourselves like a child. If they kill us, they ain't got to worry about it, but we'll rise again. I'm not worrying about the death on this life. I will rise again. Jesus is the answer. For this world today. Y'all said you can't be able to take my joy. I'm not taking your joy. I'd say it because I love you. I say it to those out there in the world. I say it because I love you. Jesus can help you out of anything you in. Many people have killed people. Many people have tortured people. There was one man in the funeral that they killed his girlfriend. They cut her up into pieces. He still can be saved.
Amen.
Don't let that devil tell you for what you have done, you can't be saved. You still can be saved. Jesus is the answer if you just give yourself to him.
Amen.
Yeah. that saints go through. Oh, it's a beautiful thing. You know why? Because you're a son, like Jesus said. And that's a glorious thing. Paul got so gripped, so Paul got so to the point that when they go to beating him, it was joy. He laughed. Because he didn't know where he was going. We can get to that point too. When they slap us, when they talk about us, whatever they do to us, we laugh. It don't hurt us. Why did I bring it to one scripture? Hebrews. Second chapter.
Thank you. saved, there is that sin burden that is still on you that Jesus can take. When God sent Jesus, he said that his name shall be called Jesus, for he shall save his people from your sin.
Thank you.
Gracious Father, we come now and
yes.
thank you for this young man.
Yes.
Lord, bless him right now. Save him, Lord. Do it for your glory. Do it for your praise. Lord, we believe you now. Lord, do it for him. And Lord, we are testify of his greatness, Lord, we toward you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah.